This is Kirk Cassius Rifle Team in association with Mecklenburg Marbella with the Genting Arena here in Birmingham with me. Made very light work of Dixon Flores tonight inside a round. Cowley Fire added another belt to his... are they all behind you?
Everybody belts? No, I ain't got my British.
Oh. Talk to me about the first knockdown.
I just asked Max and I asked him if it was the right hand, and I think, yeah, it was the right hand, and then didn't know I could punch it hard in my right hand, to be fair.
Well, if you didn't already know, now you know.
I know. But I knew, you know what, I knew, because like, do you know when you're on the pads and that? I get told all the time, that right, you got a good right hand, keep throwing that right hand. And then I just don't really feel powerful with it, but I've got to throw it, and I threw it and landed. I didn't think he was going to get up, to be fair. And then I turned around and he's back on his feet. I thought, shit, I've got to get on him again.
But the body shot there eventually did finish him.
Yeah, I didn't even look. I didn't even throw it that hard, I don't think.
You must hit very hard because you rolled over about 9 times.
Oh, no. I said today to everyone, I said that when I woke up this morning, I felt really strong, man, really powerful. I've been working a lot on my explosiveness, you know, strength and conditioning and everything. Left no stone unturned, but it's my trainer's world top fight. Because I expected him to come out and give me hell early on. But I think he was a bit wary of my power as well. But once I landed, it was. That was it.
Did you expect it a little bit more of a test?
Yeah, I did. The game plan was just go out there and box him early on and just not take much and just pick what I can and then break him down eventually because he knew he tired after 5-6 rounds. And like he did against Kudras in the WBC title fight. But I just knew if I land clean then. Probably put
him away. Oh, it was a very clinical and ruthless display from you tonight. And like I said, talking to you before the fight in the week, you know, you said that this was sort of going to be a stepping stone for you towards a potential world title shot in the summer.
Yeah.
Now you can firmly get on Eddie Hearn's case to make that happen.
Well,
with
know,
Kono.
Yeah, of course. It's down to him now to do the job. I've just gone out there and demolished him in a round. Not many people do it. He's coming off a good win as well. He just beat someone who's 16 and over 13 knockouts. So, but I was just too much, I think.
I mean, since you turned pro, you've had a lot of injury problems and it's been a bit stopped apart for you. But a consistent run of fights and we start to see the real cow your fire.
Yeah, definitely. I just think I just need to be a bit more active. I'm not active enough. I don't know why. I've had 5.5 months out, but. You know, I've trained for a long time. I just need a bit of a break now and just before I go stale. I'll go away for a couple of weeks, regroup, come back and hopefully get a world title shot in the summer.
Do you anticipate that being your next fight or do you want to fight before that?
Just leave it down to the team and whatever they decide, whatever I'm ready for.
Prepared to travel if you had to?
If the money's right, it's all about the Benjamins.
Yeah, there's a whole world outside of Birmingham, you know?
There is a big world outside of Birmingham, but... There's a lot of money outside of Birmingham and there's a lot of money inside Birmingham as well.
I'm sure in your division he can put his hand in his pocket to get that fight over here.
Of course he can. Eddie's got to dig deep now, man. I've been boxing for peanuts for about 3 years. It's time to make some real money.
Jesus Christ. I've seen your coats. You ain't boxing for peanuts, guys. Your Moncler jacket. Your brother done well as well tonight, catching the Commonwealth title.
I was really happy. I was lucky to be able to watch it on the monitor in the changing rooms. I just try not to get too nervous and, you know, let my nerves take control of me and burn energy up. But he boxed really well and I knew he was going to do that all along. He's got unbelievable power and he's really good. Won a Commonwealth title.
What number fight did you capture the Commonwealth title with?
12th.
12th. This was his ninth.
Beat me to it.
Done that already, yeah. But it's been a very successful night for the FI brothers. So.
Yeah. And then we've got another one out in a couple of weeks. My younger brother in WSB.
Oh.
So he'll be out in your call again.
So, fighting family goes from strength to strength.
They're all your FIs, aren't
they? Your FIs, yeah. Are they all your belts there behind you?
Yeah, apart from my British in here.
You vacating that soon, wouldn't you?
I keep hold of it until I'm told to vacate it.
Yeah?
I'll vacate it when I win my world title, ain't
it? I think you might have to do it before that, wouldn't
you? Don't know. But I was meant to fight his name, Anthony Nelson. That went to purse business, but he pulled out of that anyway.
But you sort of moving off domestic.
Yeah, of course. You know, we chased the Paul Butler fight and he didn't want to know, so I don't think the Conlon wants to know either, so none of them wanna know, so you know. Like Eddie said, I'm sure we can live without them.
Yeah. concentrate on your own path. And
that's it, yeah.
If your path meets with Paul Butler or Jamie Conlon in the future, if it happens.
I'm sure when I win the world title, they'll come calling.
We shall see. All right, well, listen, Cal, thank you very much for talking to IFL TV.
Always a pleasure.
And, yeah. Hand all right?
It's a bit swelling, nothing major.
All right, okay. You're going to have a good night now. I'm going to watch Eggington. Who's your fancy from that fight?
I don't know, it's a tough one. You know, like I said before, if Eggington can drag him into a fight, he can make it his fight. If Ski uses boxing ability, then I think he can win it. I said that to John Pegg yesterday at the press conference. I said, you know, if Skeet sticks with boxing, I think he wins. I'm a straight person. I tell people how it is, what I think. But it's an interesting fight. Very, very interested in it, and I'll look forward to going out and watching it now.
All right, it's going to start soon, so we'll get ourselves out there. Cal, thanks for talking to IFL TV, and we'll catch up with you soon.
Cool, thanks.
Cheers, mate.